Well, it was a big weekend for us. You know, we had what we thought were two really good opponents coming in, a lot of history there, rivalries there, and teams we felt like would be competing for, you know, top spots in the Summit League. So we really recognized it was going to be a big weekend. I also think we recognized that we hadn't played really great basketball going into that weekend, and we had areas that we had to improve in. We hadn't played poorly, but we certainly hadn't played anywhere close to what we feel like our potential is. And in some areas we really tried to work hard on is defending the three-point line better. You know, I just think that's something our team needs to get really committed to, and I know can do a better job. And at times this weekend we were really good with that. Other times we were a little bit off with that. We really focused on trying to get better starts. You know, we want our starters to play like starters. It's great to talk about our bench and the energy that they bring and how they can help give us a boost coming in off the bench, but ultimately you need starters to play like starters. They're there for a reason. They're there to set the tone. They're there to make plays. And I thought our group this weekend really played well, all of them. And then we really focused on, you know, I think, trying to do a better job of just taking care of the ball, be more efficient in what we want to do offensively. We worked a lot on breaking some things down and trying to be real clear on what we're trying to get out of certain actions. And I think a lot of that paid off this weekend. So I was happy to see the team play well, get two wins, but more how we grew in the areas we really tried to emphasize. You know, at this point in the year, it's still pretty early. And you're not just who you are the rest of the way. We're going to change. We're going to try and grow and improve. And I thought we did a great job going into two games there and doing that. Maya, I thought, had an exceptional weekend. Really played like I think the player she can be. It's hard to think that anybody can shoot it quite that well every single game. But what I was really impressed with was just how assertive Maya was. She was back in the mode of going out there and hunting up shots and trying to make plays and not just fitting into a talented team. She really, I think, played like the best, you know, player on the team, and that's a good thing. She should aspire to do that. Peyton had an exceptional weekend. You know, had Maya not had the weekend she had, we'd probably be talking a lot more about Peyton from her weekend. She was great. Drew was really good, and Paige Meyer off the bench was good. Haley Timmer probably had one of her better weekends. So we saw a lot of people really step forward. And now as we kind of turn the page, get ready for the next one, we've got a big one, a rivalry game with South Dakota coming up that we're really looking forward to on Saturday. We'll have, you know, students back. There's a ton of positive energy on campus from watching what our football team just achieved, which is a great championship, but just a great memory that people will take with them for a long, long time. And I think that energy from what they've done here recently will carry over into winter sports, spring sports, and just be a great thing to keep moving people forward and keep us engaged. So we're looking forward to a good weekend here and trying to continue to play well.
Aaron, I was going to ask you about the football thing, just because, you know, you guys have had success at that national level, you know, going on to really big things in the tournament. They obviously get a lot of attention to that. Does that matter, like, program to program, team to team? Like, can that impact recruiting or just morale? You know, do you get together as a team to watch a game? How does it impact one team when another team in the school does something like that?
Yeah, I think it's enormously important for all of our teams to be successful in every way. When we go out and talk to fans, you can tell the energy of fans based on how everybody in the department is doing. They're all fans of South Coast State women's basketball, but they're fans of other things too. And their energy and excitement is definitely amped up, particularly when football does really well on a national stage the way that they did in a sport that just brings so many people together. So that's a really key piece for our fans and people that support SDSU. On the recruiting piece, every young person we talk to in recruiting usually has an idea of how we are in other sports too. And if they're not 100% sure, they ask, how's your football team? How's your basketball teams? How's your soccer teams? How are your volleyball teams? Whatever their family kind of has an interest in, those things come up in those recruiting conversations, I'd say almost every time at some point. And I think it just continues to speak towards a family's perspective of feeling like, you know, are we going to a great place or are we going to a great women's basketball program? And I think all of our sports would say the same thing. You know, they want young people who are looking at that overall experience and looking for success in a variety of ways. So I think it absolutely helps in that regard too. And just energy within the building. You know, I think we're talking specifically about football here, but other sports when they have success, we all spend a lot of time together, you know, we do, and we get to know each other, and we want to see each other succeed, and that success can motivate us to want to be successful, or maybe open up a door that we weren't sure if we could get through, or whatever it might be. So that success can be contagious even within the building, and that's exciting, I think, for all of us.
That's awesome. Thanks. As far as USD, obviously a completely different team, you know, than the one you most recently played. Whole bunch of new players, now a new coach, but they have obviously done some good things here in the early stages of the season. Just what do they look like to you? How are they different?
Yeah, I would say different in a lot of ways and similar. You know, there's some connections there between the staff and previous staff, so they have some same, I think, tendencies on the floor. A lot of motion offense is what we saw somewhat in the past, too. They shoot the three very, very well, and they have multiple players that do that, and I think that's something they've always hung their hat on in the past. They're really physical defensively. That's something I think they've done a good job with in the past. So you have some of those similarities. But I think the biggest difference is the individual people. You mentioned a different head coach, obviously, different assistant coaches. They have different, you know, starting group. The people are probably the biggest difference. But I think some of the plan and some of the things that made them good are still, I can see, in watching them as we prepare. But, you know, you lost some elite players, and I think everybody recognizes that. One was drafted in the WNBA, and having players that have been drafted before, usually when you have somebody drafted, they're pretty good, and they add to your team. So those are tough things to all of a sudden just pick up and do everything the same way we did last year, because it just doesn't always work the same with that kind of a different lineup change. But certainly I think some of those core things that made them good in the past are certainly good this year. We struggle in some of those areas. I mentioned defending the three-point line. That'll be a big challenge for us. We haven't done a very good job of that, and I think that's correctable and something we can be better at, but we just haven't done a good job of that. We have to be a little bit more balanced in what we do offensively, not in terms of like who scores or everything, but like what sets we run, what actions we get to. We can't just get locked into a couple things. We have to be a little more balanced there, and I'm sure they'll take some of those things away too.
How's Paige coming along as she works her way back in?
Yeah, Paige is doing great. You know, she's not really on any, you know, major restriction or anything like that. We've been told, hey, you can only do this, this, and this. But we're still mindful of that. Not so much in the injury piece, but just in working someone back into shape. You know, college basketball conditioning is very different than rehab conditioning. So she's really healthy, no issues there at all. It's just more of, you know, physically getting to a place where you can play more and more minutes. And that's building up your stamina, building up your strength in other areas. But I think she looks fantastic. You know, unfortunately, all of us in college athletics have had players come back from injuries. And I don't like to compare much of anything that we ever talk about, but she looks really good, in my opinion. You know, I don't see a lot of hesitancy. I don't see a lot of, you know, spots on the floor she can't get to or cuts she's not quite willing to make. If anything, I think we're all just so surprised that she's diving all over the place. She's out there taking charges. She looks like she is ready to go. So she's been a great spark for us. And she's just such a good player. You know, on top of all these things, she's an unbelievable point guard. And Drew's an unbelievable point guard. So to have two people like that on the team at once is just, you know, crazy. Nobody gets a chance to have that. And we're lucky to do that. So we want to keep them both moving forward and doing well. But Paige has been good, and she's in a really good place.
AJ, I didn't see the games over the weekend, but you talk about Drew and Paige. Can you play them together, or do you take one off and on, or how does that work?
You know, if they were both 100%, you know, healthy, because they're both battling a little bit. I know I've said Paige is healthy, but getting in shape healthy, you know, and Paige hadn't been dealing with her injury, we'd play them a ton together, I think, because they're just both elite players. They're such good passers. They're both can make shots. It's just, they are as good as it gets when it comes to point guards, and for sure we would. I think part of why we haven't more now is because they're both kind of working through different things, so it's work to kind of play one or the other. But if I look back in our handful of games where they've both been available, we've certainly played them both together some in those games for sure. We practice that a good amount, so we're trying to work in that direction. I don't know that we've gotten to a point where we say this is what our lineup's going to look like in a week, a starting lineup or our first group of backups. I don't think we've quite gotten there. But, yeah, we're working towards the ability to play them both together, because when they're both playing well, we just don't want, you know, we don't want to split their talents. We want both of their talents on the floor at the same time.
Yeah, it comes down to players are players, whether it's position or not, right?
Yeah, I think so. In Paige, you know, she's a shorter guard, but in terms of her strength and explosiveness and ability to play bigger, I mean, she does. She's a handful for people. And then Drew on the other side, you know, Drew's a tremendous athlete. She's a long point guard. Very few point guards have that kind of height and athleticism. Even with an injury, you see that out on the floor. So yeah, they both can defend both of those spots really well. I don't think that's an issue for us. They both can play off the ball. They don't have a selfishness that sometimes point guards can have, like, that's my ball, that's my territory, that's my deal. You know, neither one of them has that. And so, yeah, I think they really can. And like I said, if they weren't both kind of in their place with injuries and things, I would suspect we'd play them a bunch together all year. But it just kind of worked out where we can be a little bit opposite. But I don't see that it has to be that way going forward, for sure.
All right, you talk about defending the three-point line against USD and going forward. Has it just been losing shooters? What have you not done well guarding the three-point line so far?
Yeah, you know, I'd say everything, and I'm not trying to sound negative, but we lose people. We lose people in screening actions. There's a few screening actions teams have tried to use against us, and we just don't handle it really well. So we got to find a better plan there and be clear about that, practice it better. I don't think we've defended with the kind of aggressiveness that we're capable of for a long time, and that really shows up in the three-point line. Our tendency has probably been a little bit to be more passive on the perimeter, try and keep people in front of us. Ultimately, I don't think that that's what we're, you know, emphasizing, but I think that's kind of been our fallback or our comfort zone, and we've got to get out of that where we can, you know, trust that if we get out and put more pressure on people and someone puts it on the floor, we'll help and we'll rotate and we'll do the other things that happen behind the three-point line. And so some of it's all of that's got to come together. But as a whole, we need more urgency there as a defense. We need to make sure our plan is really clear, because that's just an area where that can beat you. And we've played some games so far in our conference season where the three-point line has helped teams, you know, certainly stay in games. And, you know, we can be better there, and I hope we will.
AJ, thanks. I just got to interrupt to tell you, the Twins just signed Carlos Correa to a 6-year contract.
Is this his third, fourth, fifth, or sixth contract that he's had here in the offseason?
Third one. I'm so excited I could barely contain myself. I had to tell you.
Well, I hope this one lasts now. I hope this one sticks. No physicals. Let's just go forward and make it work.
Right. Sorry. Grant, go ahead.
I may be the only Twins fan not excited about that. But anyway, AJ, you know, you talked about defense. You know, it's kind of an open-ended one, but your offense, you know, has probably been clicking as best as it has here down the stretch. I know Maya's been a big part of that, but, you know, what has made the offense flow as well as it did, you know, especially that 100-point game last week?
Yeah, I think the easy answer there, when we all look at stats, is just we're making a lot more shots. You know, we had games where we didn't shoot it very well, so that's, I think, the easy answer, and I think there's a lot of truth to that. We've had games where I don't know that I would go back and say we needed different shots. We just didn't make many of them. But I think it goes bigger than that. I think, one, we've really worked on our spacing. We've really worked on player movement and ball movement the last several weeks. Those are kind of, for us, very rhythm kind of things. It's not like just putting in a new play is going to create a bunch of shots for us. They're very much timing things within our offense. Can we get the ball to the right spot at the right time? Can we look into the post and see through the post as how people are trying to defend that area and how does that create shots? I think we've gotten a little bit sharper with some of our just ball screen action. Having Paige and Drew in ball screens is really effective because they're both such good passers. We've worked at a lot of things, and our team has really bought into a lot of things that I think have helped create better shots, more open shots, and ultimately more made shots. And so I don't think it's just a matter of we got hot and we were cold before. I honestly think some of the shots we got before just weren't quite as good as the ones we're getting now, which goes back to some of that, like I said, spacing, timing, ball movement, just actions we're trying to be better with. But I do think there's a little bit of contagiousness to it. I really do. When you have someone go out there and make shots, it just takes pressure off everybody else. You know, if we're 0-for-5 from the three-point line and you got to take the sixth one, it's just harder, you know. So when someone like Maya plays as well as she does early, and like I said, she's out there hunting up shots and making plays, it absolutely also settles everybody down. So that's a big part of it too.
You know, and balance has got to be something pretty key too. I mean, you know, like just last game looking at it, you had 8 to 10 girls that scored, you know, and you had four in double figures. I mean, just having that, is that part of that contagiousness again, you know, where you can go to the bench and they're coming in with confidence too?
Yeah, I think so. We've always been a balanced team. You know, Maya had about as efficient of a 30-point game as you can have. You know, most of the times 30 points is 30 shots for a lot of players, and that's just not ever going to be us. But, yeah, I do think balance is important. And I also think for this team, stars got to be stars too. You know, I think both of those things are there. And a star doesn't mean you're always going to, you know, take that many shots. But we need, you know, a couple players. When Peyton, when she plays better, we're better. When Maya plays better, we're better. Haley Timmer had a good weekend. When she plays better, we're better. So we need people to step up and be stars, even in their role. They don't have to be the star of the team, but they've got to go out and I keep using the word, hunt up the things that make them a good player and make us a good team. No one's going to walk out there and just hand any of our players a shot. They're going to have to cut a little harder. They're going to have to be a little more determined. You know, our post players, same idea. No one's just going to give them a layup. And so I think balance is important. I'm 100%. That's how we've always played. But within each role, we got to have people step up and try and be a star within that role, I would say.
You know, you talked about Paige and Drew, and now, you know, they haven't played as much together because they're both not 100%. You know, not every team can say they have the, you know, the blessing of being able to have two. Yeah, they're both not 100%, but you can rotate them to the point you have a really good point guard out.
Yeah, for sure. I think we can try and move forward with that. You know, they're both really smart players, too, in terms of staying out of foul trouble, things like that that can happen in game that always change rotations. They both know kind of, you know, where they're at, and if they need a break or don't need a break, they communicate really well about that. But then additionally, which helps both of them, we've had, you know, Ellie Colbeck, I think, is a great example of what it is to be a great Jackrabbit, because here's someone that was starting for us in November and December, and we beat Louisville, we beat Rutgers, and we beat some teams with Ellie starting the point guard spot. And with Drew and Paige coming back, that's moved and changed Ellie's role. But Ellie's very capable, and she's proven it, of stepping in and playing well in key moments and helping us beat good teams. We've used Tori at the point guard spot, and there's another great example of someone that's willing to do what it takes to win. So I think Paige and Drew help each other, and I think someone like Ellie, I think someone like Tori, I think someone like Maddie, I think some of those other players help Paige and Drew because they know there's other people out there if something isn't going well for them.
Last one for me. I mean, USD has some other players that step up, but it seems like their offense runs through Grace Larkins, you know, who is really the main piece that they have back from last year, it seems like.
Yeah, I think we've come off a stretch here. We've played against three really good guards, North Dakota State, North Dakota, now USD, and each has a team, or a player, I should say, on their team who is a scoring guard that goes out there and does hunt up shots and very much is a volume type scorer. And she is that, and she does a great job for her team. And they have other people around her that make shots and can make plays, and so they have that kind of balance. But certainly she's someone that can go out there and try and get a bucket and can do it out of an offense, you know, on her own. So we'll have to have a good, you know, team plan there to try and keep her somewhat, you know, under control. But she takes a lot of shots. It's hard to slow her down, and we'll see what we can do.